Maayong hapon, kids! Kumusta? Are you ready to let your imagination fly high into the Cebuano sky and you wonder go under unto the depths of the Cebuano Sea? Our story today is one of the most popular characters in Cebuano folklore. He is our very own Visayan trickster figure, a character known to trick or fool greedy and evil but stupid kings and proud persons. These kind of stories tell us that vanity and pride will, at some point, bring the downfall of the high and mighty. And just like our previous stories, I will be reading this afternoon's story in both English and Cebuano. Are you ready, kids? Juan Pusong. There was once a very mischievous boy named Juan Pusong. He lived in a kingdom ruled by a greedy king. Kaniadto adunay bata nga pilyo kaayo. Gitawag siya Juan Pusong. Nagpuyo siya sa usa ka gingharian ubos sa usa ka hakog nga hari. One day, Juan strolled into the king's cattle farm. There were many cows. They were crowded in the mad paddle. And Juan suddenly thought of playing a trick on the king. Usa ka adlaw ni ana, misuroy si Juan sa bakahan sa hari. Labihang kadaghan sa baka. Naghuot sila sa lunangan. Og nakahuna-huna si Juan nga ilaron ang hari. Juan Pusong cut off the tails of several cows and drove them away. Then, he stuck the tails in the mad paddle. Half of each tail could still be seen. Gipamutol ni Juan Pusong ang ikog sa pipila ka baka ug gibugaw sila. Dayon iyang gitusok ang mga ikog didto sa lunangan. Makita pa ang katunga sa matag ikog. Juan then ran to the palace to call the king. Midagan dayon si Juan ngadto sa palasyo sa hari aron tawgon kini. Juan was shouting as he ran towards the king's throne. Your Highness, Your Highness, your cows, they've drowned in the mad paddle. Nagsagit si Juan padulong sa trono sa hari. Mahal nga hari, ang imong mga baka nangalumos sa lunangan. The king became uneasy with Juan's news. Ha? What happened? My cows, what a waste! And the king ran outside towards his farm. Wala mahimutang ang hari sa giasoy ni Juan. Ha? Naunsa? Ang akong mga baka? Kausik. Ug midagan pagawas ang hari padulong sa iyang bakahan. The king was out of breath when he reached his cattle farm. And he saw the tails that Juan Pusong had planted. They were waving in the wind like weathered plants. Gahangus ang hari nga miabot sa iyang bakahan. Ug nakita niya ang mga ikog sa baka nga gitisok ni Juan Pusong. Nagwarawara kini sila murag nangalaya nga mga tanong. The king bowled over what he saw. He really thought that his cows had drowned. My cows gone to waste. I would have sold them at the market. How many thousands have I lost? Cried the king. Mitiyabaw ang hari sa iyang nakitan. Kaingon niya nga nangalunod gayud ang iyang mga baka. Kausik sa akong mga baka. Ipamaligya ko unta sila sa tabo. Pila kalibo ang nawala kanako. Hilak sa hari. He called for his tenants right away. They had to be punished for not watching the cows well. I will put you to death as punishment for leaving my cows alone, the king said angrily. Gipanawag dayon niya ang iyang mga saop. Kinahanglan kini niyang silutan kay wala nila bantay pag-ayo ang mga baka. Silutan ta mo og kamatayon sa inyong gibuhat nga pagbiya sa akong mga baka. Suko nga sulti sa hari. The tenants became frightened and immediately told the truth. "Please don't, Your Highness. Juan Pusong played a trick on you. He should be the one punished," begged the tenants while telling the real story. Nangahadlok ang mga saop ug dali nga mitug-an sa tinuod. "Ayaw intawon, mahal nga hari. Gibinuangan ra ka ni Juan Pusong. Siya ang angay mong silutan." Nagpakiluoy nga sumbong ang mga saop. The king ordered a search for Juan Pusong. He was caught and brought right away before the king. Gipapangita dayon sa hari si Juan Pusong. Nadakpan siya ug gidala dayon ngadto sa hari. The king sentenced Juan Pusong to death. His voice echoed loudly. "You had me fooled and made me a laughing stock, Juan Pusong. So, I'll have you imprisoned in a cage and thrown into the sea so you'll drown." And right away, Juan was put inside the cage. Gihukman sa hari nga si Juan Pusong patyon. Galanog-lanog ang iyang tingog. "Imo man kong gilimbungan o gihimong katawanan, Juan Pusong. Mao nga ikaw akong ipapriso sa hawla ug ipalabay sa dagat aron ka malumos." O gipasulod dayon si Juan sa usa ka hawla. It was early in the morning the next day. The guards were not yet awake. A merchant passed by Juan Pusong's cage. On seeing him, Juan shouted, "No! I will not marry the princess. I don't want her." Sayok kadto sa buntag sunod adlaw. Wala pa mga mata ang mga bantay. Usa ka negosyante miagi duol sa hawla ni Juan Pusong. Pagkakita ni Juan kaniya, misyagit siya og kusog. Dili ko magpakasal sa prinsesa. Wala ko'y gusto kaniya." When the man heard this, he said to himself, "Is this boy out of his mind? Luck has come to him, but he won't accept it. How nice it would be to marry a princess. I would become rich fast." Pagkadungog sa tawo ni ini, miingon siya sa iyang kaugalingon, "Naa kaya sa saktong pangisip ning bataa? Miduol na niya ang swerte, di na noon niya dawaton. Kanindot raan ang maminyo og prinsesa, madato gyud ko anag dali." The man went to Juan Pusong's cage and said, "Don't cry there. If you like, I'll take over your place. I'll be the one to marry the princess." Miduol ang tawo sa hawla ni Juan Pusong og dayong ingon, "Ayaw naghilak diha. Kung musugot ka, makigilis kunimo og lugar. Ako nalay magpakasal sa prinsesa." And they hurriedly swapped clothes. The man let Juan out of the cage. He then took Juan's place inside. "The guards will be here anytime now. Tell them right away that you've agreed to marry the princess," Juan said. Then Juan quickly ran far away. Og dali-dali silang nag-ilisay og sapot. Gipagawas sa tawo si Juan gikan sa hawla. Siya'y mipuli sa sulod. Muabot na karon ang mga sundalo. Ingnadayon sila nga musugot na kang magpakasal sa prinsesa. Maoy tugon ni Juan kaniya. Human, midagan dayon palayo si Juan. When the soldiers arrived, the man shouted at them. He pretended to be Juan Pusong inside the cage. "I will now marry the princess. I will now marry the princess." Pag-abot sa mga sundalo, misyagit ug kusog ang tawo. Nagpakaaron ingnon siya nga si Juan Pusong sulod sa hawla. "Magpakasal nako sa prinsesa. Magpakasal nako sa prinsesa." The soldiers laughed hard. They thought Juan had gone mad. And they immediately brought the cage to the sea. Nangatawa og maayo ang mga sundalo. Kaingon nilang nabuang nagyud si Juan. ug iladayong gidala ang hawla sa dagat. Gilabay kini dito. Several days passed. People saw Juan Pusong again. He was wearing the nice clothes of a merchant, and he went to see the king in the palace. The king was startled when he saw Juan. Miagi ang pipila ka adlaw. Nakit-an si Juan Pusong sa tanan. Nagsulob siya sa nindot nga sapot sa usa ka negosyante. Ug miatubang siya sa hari didto sa palasyo. Nakugang ang hari pagkakita niya kang Juan. Juan, is that you? But I had you thrown into the sea. Didn't you die? Juan was about to be seized and thrown into prison again. But he said, I have a message for you, Your Highness. I was there under the sea, and guess who I met there? Your dead parents and relatives. They are happy and rich there. They want you to visit them so you can see their grand houses. Juan, ikaw ba kana? Gipalabay man unta tika sa dagat. Wala di ay ka mamatay. Ipadakop na pod unta si Juan og ipapriso. Apan miingon siya. Na ako'y tugon alang nimo, mahal nga hari. Dito ko sa ilalom sa dagat. Og kahibalo ka kinsay naabtan nako. Ang imong nangamatay nga ginikanan og paryente. Malipayon og adunahan kaayo sila dito. Gusto nila mo bisita ka dito aron makit-ani mo ang ilang nindot nga mga balay. The king would not have believed Juan Pusong. But Juan promised that the king could come back alive just like him. The king wanted badly to see again his parents and relatives. And he wanted to see their beautiful houses. Dili unta mutuo ang hari kang Juan Pusong. Apan, mipasalig si Juan nga makabalik ra ang hari nga buhi pareho niya. Gusto gyud sa hari nga makita pag-usap ang iyang mga ginikanan o paryente. O gusto niyang makita ang ilang matahom nga mga balay. The king had himself locked inside another cage. Then he commanded his servants to throw into the sea. Nagpabutang ang hari sulod sa laing hawla. Unya iyang gisugo ang iyang mga tawo sa paglabay niini sa dagat. And the greedy and stupid king died. And Juan Pusong became renowned for his cleverness. He now became the king. Og namatay ang hakog og kwanggol nga hari. Og si Juan Pusong nabantog man tungod sa iyang kaabdik. Siya na hinuon maoy na himong hari. Kids, did you like this folktale of Juan Pusong? What do you think of Juan Pusong? Do you find him a swindler and cunning? Or was he right in fooling the king? Do you think the king deserves to be fooled and dethroned? Is it rightful for Juan Pusong to become king? Tell us what you think of the tale, kids. Ask your parents or teachers to send us a message at facebook.com/gabiisakabilincebu. Also, there are questions at the end of this video that we will be posting so you can talk more about the stories with your parents or teachers. Just remember that we have storytelling afternoons every second Friday of the month in Handurawan Cebuano Tales for Children. Bye-bye, kids!